Another pickup for the Democrats. CNN projects that Donna Shalala will be the next representative from the from Florida in the House 27th District, defeating Maria Elvira Salazar. She's a former Bill Clinton cabinet member, Secretary of Health and Human Services, went on to become the president of the University of Miami. Donna Shalala will take this seat. It's Ileana Ross Layton's seat, the Republican who had served in this district for many, many years. She retired. This is a pickup. This is a pickup for the Democrats. As a result, Democrats must now pick up 21 more Republican seats in order to become the majority without losing any of their own. This is a significant win for the Democrats in the Miami area of Florida right now. So they need 21 right now. How many are they leading in, John, as we see this pickup for the Democrats in Florida?
They're leading in 15 Republican held seats. Republicans are leading in 2 Democratic held seats. I just want to emphasize in some of these districts, one of them's right here in the middle of Oklahoma, the Democrats were not expecting to pick up a seat in the middle of Oklahoma tonight. So we'll watch as the results come in. The Republican incumbent is Steve Russell. We show you some of these results. We saw a race in Texas. We showed you the Republican was leading, went back to the Democrats. We showed you. So let's just be careful as we do this. But we just want to see. You see the results start to come in. You think, okay, are the Democrats winning the districts they thought they would win? And B, are there any surprises out there? Either way. So we'll keep an eye on that seat in the middle of Oklahoma to see if the Democrats can pick that up. That would be a bonus, if you will, on this night. Again, we mentioned Republicans right now leading in Jim Cooper's district, longtime House member from Tennessee, but it's a pretty low vote count. So we have to see how that one plays out. We'll come back in. So you're looking at the Democratic opportunities now. How do you keep building and keep building? Again, the Kentucky race where they were leading, they're no longer leading. One of the Virginia races where they were leading, they were no longer leading. So it's the bigger list has been winnowed down a bit, at least as we start looking through these races. But you do have targets of opportunity. Here's one in Ohio, Troy Balderson. Again, this was on our list of races to watch. 3% reporting, so we still have a ways to go. Remember, there's a governor's race going on out here, a Senate race going on as well. 3% Democrats, that's one that they're keeping an eye on out there. We come back in. When the polls close at 8 o'clock, a couple of targets for the Democrats in New Jersey. Just want to come back in here and look here. Some potentials in North Carolina, we'll keep counting, and one potential in South Carolina. Again, this would be a surprise, but we'll keep looking.
We ought to go to Dana. She's got a key race alert in the Senate.
That's right, Wolf. We're checking in on 4 battlegrounds in the Senate, starting with Texas. This is something that, again, nobody thought that they would ever see, even though it is early in the night. Beto O'Rourke, the Democrat, is ahead. 51% of the vote. The incumbent Republican, Ted Cruz, is trailing right now, 48.4% of the vote. Not only has this been a marquee race, this is, if you look at the big picture, one of those seats that Democrats are hoping to turn over, to flip, if they have any shot at taking back the Senate. Again, about a third of the vote in Texas. It's the same story for Tennessee. This is an open Republican seat. Democrats were hoping to take back. Right now, the Republican candidate, Marsha Blackburn, is ahead with a significant lead, 66% of the vote and change. The Democrat, Phil Bredesen, is behind. Indiana, Mike Braun, the Republican challenger, is ahead in this race, 55.6% of he has that much of the vote. Joe Donnelly, the incumbent Democrat, only 40.3%. This, again, is Trump country, but a Democrat there. Republicans are trying to take it back. Same story in Florida. The Republican challenger is ahead, but it is still very, very close. 50.2% of the vote for Rick Scott, the Democratic incumbent, third-term incumbent. Bill Nelson is trailing at 49.8%, 91% of the vote in. We are going to watch Florida all night long, Nia.
We are, Dana. And speaking of Florida, we're going to look at this governor's race. An update here, Ron DeSantis still in the lead at this point by about 0.8 points over Andrew Gillum in this race, 91% reporting. It is tracking with that Senate race we just looked at, a 56,000 vote lead for Ron DeSantis. Such a contentious race, a very tight race going in, and we can see that now. Still a tight race, 91% reporting. Obviously, more vote to come in the south of Florida. In Ohio, we'll go up to the Midwest now. Richard Cordray, the Democrat, in this race, up by about 56,000 votes over the Republican, who's the attorney general in Ohio. He is trailing at this point by about 31% reporting at this point. Why is Ohio important? Because it's in the Midwest. In Georgia, another race we're closely tracking, Brian Kemp ahead here, 158,000 votes at this point above the Democrat in this race, Stacey Abrams, who, of course, is trying to become the nation's first African-American woman governor. 16% reporting. We're going to keep an eye on this race, and I'm hand you over to Wolf.
All right, Jake, let's take a closer look at what's going on. Step back and look at the big picture.
Okay, it's very interesting. First of all, we have these three nail-biting races right now. In Florida, we have this person running for Senate, the incumbent governor, Rick Scott, is up by 0.45%. There was, I think, only 91%, not only, 91% of the vote in. This was projected to be a tight race, but I don't think anybody knew how tight it was going to be. And Democrats did seem to have an edge in a lot of the in the polling at the last minute. But right now, Rick Scott is up in the Senate race, and not coincidentally, Ron DeSantis running for governor is also up. We also have in the Texas Senate race right now, and it's early, Beto O'Rourke is leading over Senator Ted Cruz. Again, it's very, very early. We don't expect that that necessarily is going to be the end result, but it is still, those are the results as of right now. And then in West Virginia, the Democrat Joe Manchin is ahead, but still a close race as of right now. So right now, if anybody was thinking this was going to be an early night and a lot of early projections for some of these races we didn't know about, no, it is not.
It's going to be close, and it's going to be a nail biter for a lot of these Democrats and Republicans in these states.
And right now in the House side, remember, Democrats need to pick up a total of 23. We have called now two races for the Democrats. Both of them are women running in seats previously elected, represented rather, yeah, by other women, Republican women.
Take a look at this. 15 Democrats in the House contest are leading in Republican districts in races that are still too early to call. Democrats must pick up now 21 Republican seats. They started the night with 23.
Yeah, and as John has pointed out at the Magic Wall, just because somebody's leading in a Republican district right now doesn't mean ultimately that's where it's going to end up. And yet, right now, Democrats are projected to, we've already called two of them, in Northern Virginia and in Florida, flipping from Republican control to Democratic control. Now Democrats only need to flip to 21 more, and it's only 8:30.
And they're leading in 15 of those districts right now. So there's potential that the Democrats clearly have. Let's look at how close the contest for Florida Senate, Florida governor are right now. We'll put the numbers up on the screen so our viewers can see them, because it's getting very, very close in both, but there's still plenty of votes outstanding. Look at this. Rick Scott is ahead 50.4% to 49.6%. He's ahead by 56,000 votes. 92% of the vote is in, but there's still plenty of Democratic votes out in those southern Florida counties, Miami-Dade and Broward County. We'll see what happens in Florida. That's the Senate contest. In the gubernatorial contest, look at how close it is right now. 49.9% to 48.8%, 92% of the vote is in. Ron DeSantis is pulling ahead. He's got an 80,000 vote lead right now, just changed to 79,000 vote lead. So it's very close, but there's still some outstanding potentially Democratic votes in those southern Florida counties.
Once again, it seems to suggest that when people talk about polling, they don't talk enough about the margin of error, because both Gillum and Nelson were polling ahead of the Republican, the Republicans they are running against, but right now they are losing to them. Something that is fascinating that I think is going to be a subject for a lot of people in days to come is there has never been a poll that I saw before Election Day where Gillum was not ahead of Nelson. Gillum, the Democratic candidate for governor, was not ahead of Nelson, the incumbent Democratic senator, even though they're running in two different races. And yet, if you look at the results, the actual votes, more people voting for Nelson, at least as of right now, than Gillum, which suggests that either the polling has just completely been off, or there have been people who said they were voting for Gillum, but ultimately did not vote for Gillum.